This is part 5 of adding and subtracting rational expressions that have different denominators. We're just going to continue working more problems, mixing it up. All right, here's a problem. Remember, we begin by factoring the denominators because we need to figure out what the least common denominator is and write each fraction in terms of that. So for the first fraction, we have a 5x minus 1 in the numerator. I'm going to put a parenthesis around that. And in the denominator, we have x squared minus 4x plus 4. That's a perfect square. You could either write it as x minus 2 squared or x minus 2 times x minus 2. And I'm going to leave room in case I need to multiply that by something. Then we look at the next fraction, minus. We've got a 3x plus 1 in the numerator. And in the denominator, I need to factor that. I could take out a 3 times an x plus 2. And I'm going to leave some room in case I need to multiply that fraction by anything. Okay, so I'm going to look at my first fraction here. And oops, I wrote this wrong. This is a 3 times x minus 2. Here we go. When I factored, it's 3 times x minus 2. That's going to make a difference. So I look in this denominator, and it looks over to the right, and it doesn't have a 3 for a factor. So I need to multiply this by 3 over 3, and there's a x minus 2. It already has that. So the least common denominator is going to be 3 times x minus 2 times x minus 2. So for my second fraction, what I'm missing is a factor of x minus 2. Right, so now we know what the least common denominator is, so I could write everything over that least common denominator, 3 times x minus 2 times x minus 2, and it's fine with me if you want to write that as x minus 2 squared. Either way is fine. And we need to simplify each of the numerators and subtract. Okay, so for the first one, I've got to do 5x minus 1 times 3, so we're going to have to use a distributive property here with a 3. So that's going to give me 15x minus 3. And here's the trick. It says subtract. Well, I need to multiply these two together. So I'm going to put a parenthesis around what it's going to be after I multiply together. So I need to do the FOIL method or any other method for multiplying two binomials. So I have 3x times x is 3x squared. Okay, let's do the outer term and the inner term. The outer term is negative 6x, and the inner term is plus 1x. So that gives me a minus 5x. And the last term will be 1 times negative 2, which is minus 2. So I need to distribute my minus sign through there now. So this will give me 15x minus 3, and I'm going to now distribute my minus sign, minus 3x squared plus 5x plus 2, and the denominator is still 3 times x minus 2 times x minus 2. The problem that goes on and on and on. Keep track of everything here. Okay, so in the numerator, I still have to combine all the like terms. So I have a negative 3x squared. I have a 15x plus 5x. So that's going to be plus 20x. And then I've got a negative 3 and a plus 2. That's a minus 1. And in the bottom, I have 3 times x minus 2 times x minus 2. Now, the next step would just be to see if I could factor the numerator. And I can't. Okay, that's not going to factor. So you could leave your answer like this. Or, like I said, you can write the denominator as 3 times x minus 2 squared if you want. All right? The other thing you can do is, I usually do this, if the leading coefficient, like the highest exponent term, has a minus sign, I sometimes write that out to the front. So you just have to be aware that there are different ways of writing this answer. If you write it out to the f right in front of the fraction bar, that means you could change all the signs of the numerator. You don't do it for both the numerator and the denominator. So it's 3x squared minus 20x plus 1 is another way of writing that answer. And I'm going to write this as x minus 2 quantity squared. So those are a couple ways that you might write the answer to this problem. It's important to recognize that there isn't just one way you might see the final answer written. So if you've got some different signs, see if that's what happened, if you put the minus sign out in front. Okay? But it's perfectly fine the way it is here. It's just recognizing that if you're checking your answers, it might look a little bit differently sometimes. All right, here's our next problem. So remember, the first thing we do is we check to see if we have a common denominator, and if not, we factor the denominators. Well, one of the denominators here is 3 minus x, the other one is x minus 3. Those are opposites of each other, right? In other words, if you multiply one of them by negative 1, it would look like the other one. So we either need to rewrite the first or the second fraction, so that it has the same denominator as the other one. So let's say I take the second fraction and multiply it by negative 1. And the reason I'm doing the second fraction is just because I happen to have some space to the right here, just showing I'm going to multiply top and bottom by negative 1. Now remember, this is a whole quantity on top here, right? So what do I have? In my first fraction, I just have 7x over 3 minus x. And in my second fraction, when I do x minus 3 times negative 1, that's also going to be 3 minus 6. This is just giving me the same denominator. Now it's true that I could multiply negative 1 through what's inside parentheses, and then when I distribute my minus sign, it'll happen again. So it's easier actually to think of this negative sign in front of the fraction times that negative 1. That just makes this a plus right there. And I'll still have that 4x plus 9. So basically, what I did was I did this plus sign times that negative 1, and that changed that to a plus. All right, so now that I have a common denominator, I can add the numerators. So that gives me 11x plus 9 over 3 minus x. Okay, I want you to do one that's similar. Okay, try this on your own and then come back and see if you get the same answer. Right, again, the denominators are almost the same, they're opposites. Remember, if one was an x minus 3 and an x plus 3, that would not be opposites. It's because there's a minus sign and the first and last term are just switched. So how about if I multiply the second fraction by a negative 1. Of course, this is in parentheses. Then this new denominator will be x minus 3. It will be the same. So this gives me 7x over x minus 3. And then what's going to happen over here? I have to do negative 1 times what's in the parentheses. So that's a negative 4x and a minus 9. And in the denominator, I'm going to have an x minus 3. When you multiply 3 by negative 1, it's really a negative 3 plus x. I could write that as x minus 3. So now I have a common denominator of x minus 3. So I could add the numerators. All right, so we have 7x minus 4x minus 9. That gives you a 3x minus 9 if you add those together. And now we need to factor. See if anything cancels. So in the numerator, if you factor out at 3, that gives you x minus 3. And in the denominator, it's already factored. All there is the x minus 3. Those cancel. So in the end, guess what? This reduces to just 3. Isn't that amazing? That first problem is just a tricky way of writing the number 3. Right, on the next video, I'm going to do a more complicated problem. Takes a while to get all the different kinds of addition and subtraction with rational expressions. Just keep working on it. Just do the same problems over and over if you need to till they start making sense.